And now let's start with this differentiation. So I will first start for the distinguishable particles, which is case one. And case one is the distinguishable particles. And what is the Q for the distinguishable particles? We have already written that one. So there is Q, N1, N2 and all this. So I will not repeat that one, but will write my G value directly. And here the G is equal to, means this is understood that G is equal, this is G of X1, X2, and so on. So here it will be G of N1, N2, and so on. This is understood. So I am not writing the variables. Let's see, let's for one, I write G, N1, N2, and N3, and so on, because it's a function of which. These are the variables. This is our G, and in short, I will write it is equal to G, and this is equal to log of Q, and I will put the value of Q from there, plus alpha times the value of N. This one I will put summation on N. Now I will not write I runs from 1 up to infinity, this is understood, plus beta and E minus summation on N, and this is the NF E N. So these are the, this is the equation. Now this equation is equal to log of N factorial into product of this. So N factorial into the product, and the product is also on N. So I will write N here. Then dN factorial divided by this is dN to the power NN and divided by NN factorial. This is our Q. So I have written the Q here plus the rest of the conditions. And the rest of the conditions are alpha times N minus N plus beta times E minus this. So I am not repeating them because we want to calculate this way. And now we will apply the rules of the logarithm. There are two rules which we will follow the most. The first one, log if m and n are re-multiplied, let me write this thing is n is here, so it is repeating, so let me write this thing is x and y. Log of xy is equal to log of x plus log of y, and log of x over y is equal to log of x minus log of y. These two we will utilize, and to utilize them, let's start here. So what it will be, these two are in product form, so first we will write log of this one multiplied by log plus log of this. So the two formulas that we will find, log of xy equal log of x plus log of y, and log of x over y will be log of x minus log of y. So we will apply them here. So the very first one, this is x and this is y. So we will first write them in a addition form. And here this is equal to log of n factorial plus log of dn mn over nn factorial, and plus the rest of the terms alpha and the first constraint and beta the second constraints here. Now we will apply on this one. Okay,
particular.
Okay. Like we are having this one. Now all the terms here are being multiplied. So where it will go? It will go to summation. Like when you apply the log on this one, then plus is here. So it will convert into summation. The pi, the product will go to summation. And now summation will be on 1, 2, 3 and so on. But if we are treating the generalized form, this is the init term we are treating. So it doesn't need any summation. So it doesn't need, means as we are treating the init term, so this doesn't need any summation and the product is wrong here. Now what this will be, log of m factorial, this let me write it as log of n factorial plus again the second formula we will apply log of d n to the power n and minus log of n factorial and plus alpha the first constraint and beta the second constraint here. This is fine. Now here we are having another relation of the log that if we are having log of x to the power n, then we can write this equal to n log of x. So powers comes in here and this is equal to log of n factorial plus n m and log of d n minus log of n n factorial and plus alpha and plus beta. So finally we got our equation that g is equal to this. And now there is one thing that we will have to focus here, that the total number of particles, they are too huge. We are having a large ensemble of particles. Similarly, the particles that you will distribute are also big in number. Like N1, N2 and all these, they are big in number. So when you are having both N and NN too big, then you can apply, you can convert the factorial into a general relation by using the Stirling's approximation. And what the Stirling approximation is, this is an approximation which converts the factorials. And that approximation is, if you take the log of z factorial, then this is approximately equal to z log of z minus z, and this is for z very greater than 1. When this number is huge, you take its factorial, then this will be equal to z log z minus z. This we call the Stirling's approximation. This is Stirling's approximation. So we will utilize this relation and our g will come out to be equal to n log n minus n plus n n log d n minus, now apply on this one as well, it will become n n log n n and then minus n n, but as one minus is here, so it will become plus n n, and then our rest of the relation in the relation is plus alpha times the n minus summation on n n n and plus beta at e minus summation of n h n e n. So this is the g relation that what we wanted to derive. And now we will apply the rule, and the rule is clearly g, or clearly xn is equal to 0. So xn is nn. We will now apply this on this one, means we will take its derivative with respect to nn. So clearly g over clearly nn is equal. What about this first term? It will go to 0 because this is constant. What about this one? It will go to 0. If even we have, if we have not expanded this one, it would be right as well, but as we have done it, so it's okay. Come here. What it will be? It will be n will become 1 and log dn will come is here. So log dn. Then minus. Now if you look here, these are two terms of nn. So we will have to apply the product rule. And the product rule is minus, and then it will be nn. And the derivative of log nn is 1 over nn plus then log nn, and this will come out to be 1. So we are having this. Then what about this one? This is plus 1. Come here, this will become 0 and this will become 1. So we are having minus 1, so minus alpha. And here, beta, this e will become 0 and here it will become minus e n. So minus beta n, minus beta e n. We got this value and this is equal to 0. Because clearly g or clearly n should be equal to 0. If I look to these terms, then nn are cancelling with one another here, and rest of the terms, okay, let me simplify first, because this comes out to be 1, it is minus 1 and it is plus 1, and they will be cancelled. So cancelling in order to do the simplifications, this plus 1 and this minus 1 will cancel, and we will have log dn minus log nn, right? Log dn minus log nn, which I can write is log dn over nn. So this will be log dn over nn is equal, means the two terms can cancel, this will come on the other side. So it will become alpha plus beta e n. And now if I just want to get rid of the log and I take the exponential on both sides, so taking the exponential on both sides, what this will means the nature law cancels the exponential, and we will get dn over nn is equal to e to the power alpha plus beta e n. And now what I want nn, because this is my variable that I am focusing. So nn will be, you will have reciprocate. So it will be, if I want to write nn, then it will be nn over dn, and this will also reciprocate. So the dn will come here, and the e to the power alpha plus beta en, it will be. So I have found the value of nn, okay, and this is dn e to the power alpha plus beta. This I can write this in terms, if I raise the exponential like this one, that nn is equal to dn and e to the power minus alpha plus beta en. And this is what the maximization will give me, the nn value. Right? The nn value is equal to dn e to the power minus alpha plus beta en.